Hi, I'm Oriana Leo with the Red Carpet Report here in Beverly Hills for a benefit of the American Ballet Theatre.
I'm here with Jeanne Kaczmarek from Malcolm in the Middle fame. Welcome. Can you tell me about what's inspired you to support American Ballet Theatre?
She's right over there, my daughter, Frances. Frances.
We'll get her.
Come here.
Oh, she's not into it.
She's a ballerina.
Okay.
She's my shy one. my daughter is a wonderful ballerina, an aspiring dancer, and ABT is one of the best there is. So it was very exciting to be able to come tonight and to be able to bring Frances and see some of the dancers that she really admires.
Absolutely. Now, how do you think dance has affected your daughter and some of the young women that are involved with it?
Oh, dancing is the most wonderful way to spend extracurricular time. Mm-hmm. I mean, with Frances, she's going to the Performing Arts High School, so she dances 3 hours at school, then she goes to her studio for 3 hours. So she dances at least 6 hours a day and on weekends. She was with the Bolshoi last summer and was dancing in the Netherlands this summer. So she's been having great opportunities to do a lot of traveling and to just do what she loves doing more than anything.
You must be so proud.
I'm very proud of her.
Okay.
I'm very proud of her.
I have to ask, do you have a favorite ballet that this company or really any company has put on? Do you have a favorite?
I think Giselle was always one I loved. And Gelsey Kirkland and Baryshnikov were the two in the 70s when I was coming along that we loved. And I know they jumped back and forth between City Ballet and American Ballet Theatre. I'm not sure who they ended up with, but there was a beautiful dancer named Tani Leclerc, who was Balanchine's, one of his wives. She was so magnificent, and she got polio. They were traveling for a European tour. And I think at the age of 28, she was in a wheelchair for the rest of her life. And that is a perfect story of the kind of drama that ballet is full of. You know, so many ballets are full of stories like this.
Right.
But she was magnificent and had great spirit, and I've always admired her.
And have you been a dancer? Have you gotten involved?
Oh, I don't think there's anything I wanted more than to be a dancer. But I have, you have to have exactly the kind of musculature and bone structure and... And I didn't have that, but the music, just listening to music, doing the ballet bar, doing the exercises, still is a favorite sound to hear.
Okay, if you could be the black swan or the white swan, which would you choose and why?
White, because I want to be a good example to my daughter.
How noble of you.
Well, she's 16, so you really want to, you know,
at that age,
emphasize all the good behavior that you can.
So now we're all having Malcolm in the Middle withdrawals. Do you and Bryan Cranston stay in touch?
We do. He is, I think the last time I saw him, I went to Broadway and saw him on All the Way, where he was playing LBJ.
Uh-huh.
You know, and you see him back, it's this magnificent performance. He won the Tony, and you see him backstage, and he's still this goofball. He's still Hal, and he's so humble. I mean, everybody loves Bryan, but this incredible success he's had, I don't know anyone who begrudges him. You know, he's so deserving of this, and he has stayed such a great guy. So, and he wants to do a Malcolm reunion movie.
Oh, my God. I vote yes.
But he's terrific. So I'm always happy to see him.
And where can we see your next project? What's going on with you?
I've really taken I have three children.
Mm-hmm.
16, 14, and almost 12. And I love being a mom, and I live in Pasadena, and there are lots of the Conservatory of Music I'm active with, and all sorts of things. Mm. So that's really my concentration now. But I do have a fabulous job on a show called Playing House, which is on the USA Network, playing the mother of Jessica St. Clair. Playing House is Lennon Parham and Jessica St. Clair as best friends. Check it out on USA Network. It is one of the best shows I've seen.
Do you know when it airs?
It was on this season, and they're waiting to hear about their season, their number two pickup.
Fingers crossed.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for your time.
Have
a great night.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for watching. And if you like this video, hit like. If you'd like to see more interviews, make sure you subscribe. And leave a comment below letting me know what's your favorite ballet. Mine is Swan Lake. See you next time.